Hello everyone, this is Lady2and3 from IMVU.com. Oh my goodness, have I got a treat for you today. I'm going to show you how to upload poses. This is just poses for furniture. I haven't figured out if it works for accessories, but I'm going to go ahead and say yes, it does. But not your average sitting pose, not the default standing pose, custom poses. I've already made the mesh, but I'm going to show you something that you got to go to real quick. You're going to need to go to IMVU.com and join the Syntec group. It's a GA group, so no worries on that. Then you're going to come down here, and where it says free poses, click on that, and it'll bring you to here. I'm going to scroll through these all the way to the bottom. And where's the one we want? We want right here. Links to poses. You're going to click this, download it. I already have mine downloaded in my SketchUp folder. You can see SketchUp free poses. And I'm going to be using, I'm going to say Faye Neil poses. And I go through and rename them. And I have found it important to rename them. You want to rename this part, your XAF file, not your image. Well, you can do the image too, but I go through and rename them. Start them off with a letter. I find that starting it off with a letter is really important on this. So just go through and rename them, like her other one that she has is just O3. But today I'm using 4 and 5 just as an example. I've already renamed them. I'm going to bring up this. Now, I've already made, you know, two nodes in my entity info. I have seat 01 and then Neil 05. Neil 05 is the name of my XAF file. So when you go into Google, you know, make it a unique texture, paint it, edit, or make component, and then your name and the definition name are going to be seat 01 for your first node, and then dot whatever the name of the file is. Over here on the second one, I'm using seat 04, or excuse me, Neil 04. So my definition name is going to be seat 02, because we have to do these in sequential order. Dot Neil 04, because Neil 04 is the second XAF file I'm going to use. I sound kind of funny today because I've been a little sick. Okay, I've been more than a little sick. This is Sunday. I've been sick since Wednesday. It's ridiculous. Alright, so just like any other furniture, you know, save it, export it, files, mesh out, export IMVU file set, and then when you go to upload it, add your XMF. And do not click apply changes yet. You've got your config with the XSF file, you got have your meshes filled out with your .xmf file. Go over to actions, hit add. Come down to add XAF right here. Find the pose that you want. Your first, add your first pose, Neil 05. Now, go below it. It says skeletal frame controls. Under loop start, hit 1. Under end, hit 5. Come up to the top where it says number ensembles played. Type in 0. Not letter O, but 0. For trigger, you're going to type stance, dot, and then the pose name. I found it really important to capitalize this first letter. I don't understand why, but I understand it has to be done. When you hit apply changes, we have the Neil 05 pose. We don't have one, we have a standing pose up here because we haven't added the other pose yet. So to add your second pose, just click add, and then it'll come up here. Same thing, your ensembles play to zero, your loop start under skeletal frame controls. Your loop start is 1, your end is 5. Add in your pose, XAF, triggers, stance, STANCE, dot. For me, it's going to be Neil04. Apply changes. Now, when we click it, we now have 2 poses on whatever mesh we've made. I wanted to give a shout out to the person that I just had a conversation with, of whom I cannot remember his name. Here. Pure Income. Like Pure Income, but Pure Income. He showed me how to do this. I was trying to go through the tutorial, but I kept missing stuff, and I could not figure out what was missing. And it turns out that I was not putting in the loop start and the end, because I don't think it is on the tutorial that I was reading. But anyways, now we know. Loop start, end 5. On, you know, every pose you upload. And just like we did with the sitting and the standing poses, you're going to want to move them back so that they fit the way you like them. But this, he was showing me some of the stuff that he had done. This is his alt account, by the way, Majestic Meshes. Everything he does, with the exception of poses, he makes his poses in 3DS, but he uploads them and builds and everything in Google SketchUp. So this, you know, this is the bed he made. And I was like, oh, you know, that's pretty cool, pretty cool. And then I was like, it has poses. Oh my gosh, it has poses! And it blew my mind, and I was like, cause he asked me, he's like, you know, I've seen your, what am I making right now? I've seen your tutorials. And I was like, oh, really? That's, you know, that's always nice to see someone who's a fan or who needs help. And he's like, yeah, da-da-da-da-da. And I was like, holy cow, hold on just a moment. You need to help me. Oh, it looks like you did the pillow thing. That's pretty cool. Look, there's, you know, the pillow in action. So, that's how you do it. Stay tuned for how to make poses using the Deliverance sticker. If you need any help, you know where I'm at. Have a good day.